think they're, what are they, 4 for 303? We're only really 2 wickets away from being able to break it open. And, you know, if the boys come out tomorrow and put the ball in the right area, I'm confident that we can get a few early breakthroughs and then, you know, hopefully get them out under 400. But in terms of, I wasn't in Melbourne, no. And so my sort of, I watched the game. So, you know, it's very similar to what we went through in the UAE, you know, with the wicket being quite good for the first 3 days and then deteriorates, the game moves quite fast towards the back end of the game. And it's going to be the same. So that's why the first innings runs is going to be key for us. Yeah, he was very classy, wasn't he? You know, his time, his patience around the crease and just the way he batted was very good. And I think it's something that I personally can take a lot from. You know, he just batted a lot of time, and I think that's something he's done through this whole series. And yeah, if you know, that's what we're going to need to do. You know, all our batters are going to need to step up and put a big score on the board. Yeah, definitely excited. You know, batting 3 for Australia, who wouldn't be excited? So, you know, on that front, it's very exciting. But also knowing, you know, my role at 3 is to play my game and to make sure that I'm batting as much time as possible and, you know, putting us as a team in a good position. And that's sort of how I'm going to approach it. So, yeah, it's... You know, there was a little bit of pressure. I sort of first ball came out all right, and I think I bowled a few drag downs that over. But I was positive. I sort of came back the last 3 overs and was able to sort of tie a bit of pressure. But you know, I know my role tomorrow is to make sure that I'm keeping it tight at that one end, giving our quicks a rest, and making sure we can come back fresh every spell.